Maria Teresa Vosa. I am a hematologist at Tor Vergata University of Rome. Today I will speak about myelodysplastic syndromes and aging. Myelodysplastic syndromes are a disease which is typically associated to aging and is significantly more frequent in elderly individuals. Very recently, somatic mutations have been found in healthy individuals over the age of 70 in particular. And these somatic mutations have been associated to an increased risk of myeloid diseases, including myelodysplastic syndromes. And this has been recognized as a significant susceptibility factor for the development of these diseases. And in myelodysplastic syndromes, the same mutations have been found at increasing frequency with aging. And some of them have been associated to specific types of MDS. Although these mutations are frequent, only some of them do have a diagnostic potential, and only some of them have prognostic potential, such as TP53 mutations in MDS. Although mutations are frequent, and especially in elderly individuals, some treatments have been shown to be effective in these patients independent from age. And this include erythropoiesis-stimulating agents, azacitidine, and also lenalidomide. So the crucial point is now to identify the patients who really benefit from this treatment, especially, for example, hypomethylating treatment, which is compelling for patients because it's a treatment which is disease-modifying, but it's not disease-eradicating. So the patient, once the treatment is started, the patient has to continue this. And so using different prognostic factors, including somatic mutations, we might be able to identify those patients who may benefit from this treatment and probably spare a cumbersome treatment to patients who do not have a high probability to respond and have where we should look for other treatment options.